From snoozing messages to creating filters, this is how to save time in Gmail. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and these are the best time-saving tips for Gmail. So Gmail tip number one is to snooze email messages in order for you to respond to them at a time that's more convenient for you. So how many times have you received an email and you don't really have time to reply back right away, or you're working on something else and you get distracted and then you forget to respond back? Well, if you hover over the email in your inbox and you click on the little clock icon that appears, you'll have the option to pick a time to snooze that email until. Meaning, if you pick, say, later this week, the email will pop back up to the top of your inbox later in the week at that time. And yes, you can pick your preferred date and time too. But you can also access the snooze feature from within an email itself. So let's say you've opened up the email. Well, now you just hit the little snooze option that's found near the top of the email message. Now here's what happens when you pick a date and time to snooze an email message. Let's click on later today as an example. And now look, the email is gone from my inbox, but don't panic. Like I said, the email will pop back up in your inbox on that date and time that you've chosen. But if you made a mistake and you're like, OMG, where did that email go? Or wow, look, I've stopped scrolling Instagram long enough that I actually could reply to that email. Well, no worries, you can do that too before it's popped back into your inbox. Just take a little gander right here at the left-hand side of your inbox and you may notice a snoozed option. Simply click on that option and voila, here we go. We've got all of our snoozed emails right here. Plus, you'll even be able to see on the right-hand side of that email the time and dates that the email are scheduled to come back into your inbox. So you can reply to any of these by just clicking on the email, or you could even unsnooze the email right from here too by clicking unsnooze. And now for Gmail tip number two, make Google Calendar events directly from emails in Gmail. I love this so much. Gmail already does a really good job of adding certain information from your emails into your Google Calendar. So as an example, hotel bookings or flight info from your Gmail should automatically be created as calendar events in Gcal for you. But you can also do this manually right from any email itself in Gmail. So not just the super obvious ones, any email. There are a couple of ways to do this. From an open email, click on the three-dot more option, then select create event. This will open your Gcal event window as a new tab, and it'll fill out information from the email for you. So you can edit any details in here. Or back in your Gmail, there's an even quicker way. With the email open, you'll click on your Google Calendar tab from the side panel directly in Gmail. If you don't see your tabs on the right, you probably just need to expand your side panel. So at the very bottom right of your Gmail, you're gonna have a little arrow where you can click to expand and collapse that side panel. So when you click on the calendar tab from that side panel, you can pick the date you want to create the event, then click on a time you'd like to create the event. Instantly, the event is created for you with details from the email automatically copied over. You can edit this and add any informational details that you see fit, but it's really that quick and easy, and you don't even have to leave Gmail. And now onto Gmail tip number three, use Gmail templates. I've mentioned this before in some of my other Gmail videos, which you can watch via the links in the description below, but this is a massive time saver in Gmail, and I am such a huge fan of this. If you haven't used templates before, click the settings gear icon and head to all your settings. From here, head to the advanced section and just make sure you enable templates, then click save changes. Now, every time you write an email, you can save it as a template or insert a previously saved template. So let's say you compose an email that you find yourself sending all the time, like maybe it's a job application. You can save it as a template by selecting the three-dot menu icon by the trash can, hover over templates, save draft as template, then choose to save as a new template. Now when you go to write that same email next time, you can head back to your templates in the compose window, and this time select the template you want to insert. Of course, you can personalize this template from the compose window here, but the rest of that work is already done for you. And if you're finding this video valuable so far, I'd love for you to give it a like and hit that subscribe button for more Google goodness. Now, on to Gmail tip number four, change your default inbox view. This is gonna be customized to whatever you find most productive. So click on that gear icon again, and this time, let's pay attention to this right-hand side quick settings panel, specifically the inbox type section. Under that default option, which is what I have here, you actually have the option to customize this if you want, so you can select the tabs you want to display for you. But back in the quick settings, maybe you function best when you have emails marked important pinned at the top of your inbox, or maybe you only want unread messages at the top of your inbox. You can adjust all of these views right here. You can put starred first at the top, but one I think could be useful to help save time in Gmail is the multiple inboxes setting. If you select the customize option here, you can select up to 5 custom sections that you want to be displayed alongside your inbox. Now, these sections are using something called search operators, which I've talked more about in a video called 5 Gmail Tips for Productivity that I, of course, have linked for you in the description below if you want more information on what the heck a search operator is. But what you can do is specify specific recipients or words in a subject line. And if you're wondering how the heck to use different search operators, you can just click on Learn More. And then in this pop-up, click on Search Criteria. And here's a list of all different kinds of search operators you can use. The next Gmail setting everyone should know is how to create filters in Gmail. Specifically, in order to save time, create filters that allow emails to skip your inbox entirely. This is going to help you keep your Gmail inbox organized and allow you to spend less time sorting messages after they've hit your inbox. Instead, sort them out automatically before they even hit your inbox. Here's how. There are a ton of ways you can use filters, and I've got a bunch of videos on that, but for this example, let's filter emails from this specific mailing list. We'll click on the email, then click on the downward arrow near my email address here at the top, and select Show Details. In this overlay, I can click to filter messages from this mailing list. This automatically creates a filter that's pre-populated for that alias. Let's click on Create Filter. And here's where it gets interesting. We can pick from a myriad of things we'd like to happen when a message matches this criteria we just set. For this, I could choose to have it skip the inbox completely, which would archive it immediately, which could be a good option if you get inundated with a bunch of emails from a mailing list, but you don't want to unsubscribe completely. But what I recommend is to leave skip the inbox toggled on, but also toggle on the option to apply the label. Now here you can choose from labels you may have already created, or you can create one right from here. Then, if you have other emails that match that criteria, you can toggle on the apply filter option here at the bottom. So that'll filter out all other existing emails like this one. Then just click on create filter. And now you're gonna see that that message, it's gone from my inbox. And not only that, but we've got the digital marketing label I created now on the left-hand panel here. And if I click on that label, bam, here are the emails we just filtered. Bingo bango, it's that easy. And my last tip to save time in Gmail is to bulk delete emails. So here's how to bulk delete emails in Gmail. There are, of course, a couple of ways to do this, but I think the easiest way is with a couple of clicks. Click on that select all toggle near the top to select all emails on the page. Once you select all emails using the toggle, you're going to be informed at the top that you've selected all the emails just on that page, but you can select all conversations from your primary inbox. You'd simply click on that to get rid of every last email in your entire inbox. But you probably don't want to delete every single email you've ever received. So you can use your filters to bulk delete emails in Gmail as well. So you can literally filter this however you want. So in your search bar at the top, maybe you want to bulk delete all emails from a specific email address. You could just search for that email address and either select all from those results, or you could use that same filter to filter only emails from that email address, then select all and delete them all in one go. Or you could filter by unread or read messages. So in your search bar at the top, you could type in is:unread, hit enter, and boom, all your unread emails will come up. Here is the same steps. Click on that select all box. You can delete per page or simply select all conversations that match this search. You get the idea. So you can search and filter down to bulk delete emails in Gmail for whatever method works best for you. But remember, when you delete emails in Gmail, they will be moved to your trash bin where they will sit for 30 days. So from your trash, you can recover an email and move it back to your inbox, or you can leave them sit there for 30 days, or you can select the option at the top to empty trash now. Once you do that, those emails are gone forever. Goodbye. And now that you can spend less time in Gmail, perhaps you can spend some of that time watching more of my videos. I've got a ton of other Gmail videos for you that go over, well, pretty much anything you could ever think of that you need to know in Gmail, and I have a bunch of them listed for you in the description below. So now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite time-saving tips for Gmail? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Gmail goodness. Thanks for watching. See you next time.